or a rough time, whatever the reasons are. And then you meet someone of the opposite sex that is also going through a rough time at the same time. And it's lucky when it happens, because usually one person ends up liking the other person a little bit too much. But sometimes both people are completely fine with using each other to get through the storm ahead. And that happened to me once, and it was nice. We kind of helped each other along, and I think that's maybe one of the only relationships that it's kind of all right to lie a little bit to their person. I think it's kind of, you know, expected. And it serves its purpose. I think those relationships are there for a reason. But be careful out there, because somebody might get hurt all over again. But it did not happen with this girl at all. And she's here tonight, actually.
Carl?
Yeah, her name is Carl. I hope Carl's here and he's just really shy. This one's called Lie To Me. I'm going to tune it real quick. Anyone have any questions to Lie To Me? I can't multitask. I'm sorry?
What makes you decide to write a song for guitar instead of piano?
I don't know really. I think it's a good question. I think I never really think about it. I never think, I'm going to write a song about this and I'm going to play it on guitar. I think it just happens. Whatever instrument I sit down at, I start playing. And a lot of times the song will be this for a long time, and I'll sing, "One of those falling love, in violets, wolves, and bombs, and bombs." Like complete gibberish. And then if I like it enough, I'll write real lyrics for it. But I never really make the conscious decision to write a piano song and or a guitar song.
Did you ever have a rapping period?
A what?
A rapping period.
A rapping period?
Rapping.
Never.
A rapping.
Rapping. Children's.
Oh, no.
What happened to Chef while you toured?
He passed away, and so thanks. No, I'm just kidding. He's even dead. No, he's alive. He's in New York. For those of you who don't know, Chef is my dog that I... he's only 5 years old. He was a little wild. I don't know why I just said that. Just thought, everyone was like, "Oh shit." I live on a fourth floor of a building, and two of my really good friends live right below us, and they love him. And so I just take him downstairs when I leave and pick him up when I come back. Sorry if I gave you like a heart attack for a second.
Is that what you do with Brandon?
Brandon's my other dog. No, Brandon's my guitar player, and I keep him downstairs as well.
What's your favorite color?
Probably something like a bone, or like harvest wheat, or I really love, you know what I love? Burnt, anything burnt I love. Burnt brick, burnt dug, burnt. You know, I had this grand, I shouldn't even say this, because it is kind of offensive, but I have this dream, not a literal dream, but like in my fantasy, that I would love to get a hold of a catalog before it goes out, like a Pottery Barn catalog or like a Gap catalog, right before it ships off to thousands and thousands and thousands of people across our entire country, and retype some of the color descriptions. Because, you know, it's like shown in Auburn Mist, and also available in Chestnut and Walnut and Burnt Rose or something like that, you know. And I would love to say, it get really dirty and really dark. Just in the nice little print. Shown in black, also available in baby. for this bass is also available in Placentia Pink. But like, yeah, so people are taking their copy and flipping through the catalog and they're like, I want to do that really bad. What's that? Oh, why not? I love New York. Still not tuned, I'm sorry guys. This guitar is very... I went to New York for the first time in a long... for the first time 7 years ago, I fell in love with it, absolutely. And then told myself I was going to move there as soon as I could do it well. I didn't want to live in a shoebox, and so I could finally live in two shoeboxes right next to each other.
What side of town?
I'd like to call one of my life ones. I don't know the answer to that question. I'm not really sure I understand the question. Do I take what it left? Oh, right. Well, no, I do say orange now instead of orange, which makes the knock-knock joke a lot more funny. Orange, aren't you excited to be here? But orange, I grew up saying orange, and I'm like, orange, you glad I'm here? No, it's not funny, dude. I think that's a Brooklyn joke, to be honest. Florida oranges. Ready to play a song now. Thanks for bearing with me.
I don't mind playing the fool.
high.